Bless the Lord. Hello, hello, Derek Lynn. We're praying for America and time spent with the word. Father, we are so grateful on today for the grace to come and search the scriptures. For you said in your word, search the scriptures, for in them you think you have eternal life, and they are they that testify of me. So, Father, we come to testify of the goodness of our God. We come to testify that his mercy endures forever. We come to testify that there is nobody like our God. We come to testify that our God is God, and he is God all by himself, as we pray for America in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, as I'm preparing to come and to pray for America publicly, I'm hearing in my spirit revolution. At first, I thought it was revelation, but it was revolution. And revolution basically means you are coming in to take over something and to reinstate or install. So you are getting rid of an old system. Oh my God, thank you, Holy Ghost, for this insight. You are getting rid of an old system and you are desiring to bring in a new system. Now, let's go to the Bible, because we always have to have a scripture to back up what we are saying. Amen. Matthew chapter 11, verse number 12. The Bible reads, "And from the time John the Baptist began preaching until now, the kingdom of heaven has been forcefully advancing, and violent people are attacking it." You see that? Since John showed up on the scene with his locust, his bug-eating self, and his honey and bug-eating self, and his wearing of camel hair self, come on, somebody. Since Brother John the Baptist showed up on the scene, the Bible tells us that the kingdom of God continued to forcefully advance. That means the word of God was spreading. The word of God was getting out, and people were hearing the word of God to the point where John was not afraid to stand up before a wicked and evil king and tell him, "The woman you're with is not your wife. That's your brother's wife. You are in sin. Get out of sin and repent." My God, whoo, where are the bold Johns of Baptists in the land today? Where you're not afraid, you said, but oh, you can't do that. You have to be very careful. You don't want to get in trouble. See, that's the problem. The church has been so careful and don't want to get in trouble and not preaching the word of God as it is supposed to be preached. The time is out for cuteness and oh, you have to use wisdom. Of course, we're going to use the word of wisdom. Of course, we're going to use the God-given wisdom. Of course, we're going to use the spirit of wisdom. But I'm telling you, when it comes to the word of God, we got all the wisdom we need, and we will give the word as the word is the word. And if someone questions what we say, refer them back to the word. The time is out for the church being so careful and not want to offend. Jesus says, offense will come. Period. Come on. It has to come. Jesus offended everything and everyone everywhere he went. Mm-hmm. Yes, he did. And we are made in the image of God and after his likeness. Hello, somebody. Ooh, God help me today. Mm-mm. I'm supposed to be praying for America, and I find myself preaching. That's the thing. When you get into this thing, you get into this word, it is so rich. Revelation just come because the Holy Spirit sees fit to release them, and we are grateful to God for them, and our God gets all the glory, the honor, and the praise belong to him. But I want to focus on something. So the kingdom of heaven is forcefully advancing, but then the other part of that, it says, and the conjunction going into the continuation of it, it says, and violent people are attacking it. And violent people are attacking it. Don't look any further. Just look around. Look around. Violent people are attacking believers. Violent people are attacking the gospel. Violent people are attacking the kingdom of God. This is why when I heard the Spirit of the Lord say to me revolution, I thought it was revelation, but he said revolution. We need to see the revolution of the word of God. What does that mean? We are getting rid of the old systems in the church. Come on now, somebody, because it always starts with the church. Judgment begins in the house of God. Everything God does, he always starts in his house first. If the Lord is cleaning the house, he starts with his house before he goes to the nation. So, it will behooves us to get right. It will behooves us to stay right, because righteous living is still right. Come on. Sanctification is still right. Yes. Right standing with God is still right. Holiness is still right. Oh, there's nobody holy. He says, be ye holy, for I'm holy. And the Holy Spirit will help us to be holy. With his help, we can do anything. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. But why will violent people attack the kingdom of God? Because they do not want the kingdom of God to advance. And this is why we can be cutesy and not wanting to, oh, we don't want to get it. No more cutesiness. Just preach the word. Tell the word of God like it is. And someone has questions, give them the reference where it is, and pray that when they go and search it out for themselves, the Lord will meet them right there and reveal to them what he's trying to say through you. And by the grace of God, they too will, if they're not saved, get saved. And they too will be on fire and carry the same gospel. Jesus Christ coming, being born of a Virgin Mary, suffering on a Pontius Pilate, crucified, dead and buried, resurrecting from the dead, ascending into heaven, seated at the right hand of God the Father. And he will be coming back. Because that's literally the gospel. That's the word of God. And so we pray for America today, that there would be the revolution of the word of God spreading throughout this country, where the old systems that hasn't worked to date be removed and a new system be brought in. And that system is operated through, for, with, and by the word of God. Because one thing's certain, it is not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord. So, Father, I pray that your word will become revolutionized in America. That, Father God, the word of God would take center stage in this country. That the word of God would take center stage in the church. Start with the church. And the word of God would take center stage in the White House. The word of God would take center stage in the Supreme Court. The word of God would take center stage, my God, in Jesus' name, in the Capitol building. The word of God would take center stage in our schools. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the word of God would take center stage in all these filth, evil, abominable acts and things that have been allowed in this country to date would dissipate and disappear in the powerful name of Jesus Christ, because light and darkness cannot stay in the same place at the same time. Father God, let the light of your word shine for all to see, and that Jesus be lifted up and all men be drawn unto him. This I pray over America today in Jesus' name, so shall it be. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace. And know this one thing. Oh my God. I was going to say put on the armor, but he said, no, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Because when you're strong in the Lord and in the power of his might, it will be easy to put the armor on. There's no need telling you daily, put the armor on when you're not strong in the Lord. You have to be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Then put on the whole armor of God, knowing that we don't wrestle against flesh and blood. It makes no sense being attacked by spiritual wickedness in high places and we are bare. We don't have no armor. No, be strong in the Lord. Put on his armor so when the fiery darts are being fired at us, we can fire back like Jesus fired back as Satan and said, it is written. So we can fire back and say, it is written. The word of God says this to the situation that we're faced with. Oh my God, until the next time, be blessed in the Lord. Have a fabulous, blessed day. Please don't let no one who cannot make a day mess up your day. And we cover ourselves from the top of our heads to the soles of our feet with the precious poured out blood of Jesus Christ. And until then, shalom.